Good evening, judges and audience. I'll be talking about my paper, which is Retroillumination Image Marking, the novel method of toric aisle reference axis marking using the iToric Android app. I have no financial interest. iToric is an Android application developed by me. It is available free of cost on Google Play Store. As we all know, toric aisle is all about perfection in alignment of the IOL, and it starts with the reference marking. We have various devices to mark it. The standard is bubble marker. We also have the costlier electronic devices, and there is also smartphone-based apps such as iToric. I will briefly tell you about iToric app because I'm used it during the study. Basically, with the smartphone-based app, you have to mark the limbus either freehand or you can use the standard bubble marking. And then we have to click the image of the patient's eye using the iToric Android app like this. And then we have to place these red dots, which are available in the app, on these marks. And then the screen gives you all this information, which corrects the camera rotation and the rotation of the mark. So that, for example, if I want to place the lens at 173 degrees, it gives us the corrected axis at 169 degrees after correcting all the rotation and the error in the marking. What if the pre-op marking is not possible? We have this markerless system, which are fairly expensive. I thought during one of the cases that there is a very good red reflex in many of these cases we operate, and there are these lenticular opacities, and can I use this image for toric aisle alignment? So the purpose of my study is to check the feasibility and accuracy of retroillumination image axis marking using iToric Android app as compared to the conventional bubble marking. It is a case series where I compared both the marking systems in 54 eyes of 54 patients. I excluded all the patients with mature cataract because no retroillumination image was possible. All the eyes to be operated were dilated, and retroillumination image was captured using the infrared camera, which is available in all the autorefractometers. I used the UWITS autorefractometer HRK 8000 for this particular study. And after taking this retroillumination image, the image was captured using the iToric Android app. Before the surgery, I used the standard manual marking 0180 degree using the bubble marker. And using this as a reference, a random axis, which is between 90 to 180, was marked. The measured axis was again compared with the axis marked by the iToric using the autorefractometer image. Just to give you an example, this was the two marks which were marked by using the bubble marker. So this is the conventional marking. And these are the lenticular opacities which I have marked using the autorefractometer image. So now on table, I mark, for example, say 90 degree axis, using the conventional marking like this, and then the retro image marking like this, and I compared with what was the error between the two methods. Just to give you example, for example, this is the one of the patient's image. You can see the lenticular opacities which are seen on the retroillumination image. I have captured this image through iToric Android application, and I have marked these particular opacities using these marks, red dots. And now, for example, if in this case I wanted to place the lens at 108 degrees, so according to the this iToric marker, I have to place it 25 degrees counterclockwise to the reference lenticular opacity. So this is how I will mark intraoperatively. I can clearly see this image, the lenticular opacity intraoperatively through the red image, and I will be marking 25 degrees of it counterclockwise. And this is the lens placement at the end of the surgery. The results are retroillumination image marking can be used in almost 57% cases in my study. And for not able to use this retroillumination image, there were major two causes. The most major cause was not able to identify any lenticular opacity. For example, in this case, you can see in the left side image, you can easily see lenticular opacity, which you can mark. But in cases of nucleus sclerosis, where there are no cortical markings, it was difficult. Also, in two cases, there was a lot of corneal haze, which didn't allow me to check the marking. Even in PSCs, posterior subcapsular cataract, you can see there are some radial elements which are available, which you can mark on your retroillumination image. The error in the retroillumination marking as compared to conventional marking was around 1.25 plus minus 2 degrees, range was 0 to 5, and accuracy was within 5 degrees in all the cases in which the marked opacities were identified on table. The prerequisites for using this retroillumination image: one is good retroillumination image has to be achieved. So you should have an autorefractometer with infrared imaging facility. You should have a good microscope with red reflex and iToric Android app. It is particularly useful, I found, in uncooperative patients, particularly in pediatric cases, because it is very difficult to mark them with conventional marking, and it is also alternative to markerless system. To conclude, retroillumination image marking is a novel method which can be used in patients who do not allow standard reference marking preoperatively, and this is the first paper reporting use of retroillumination image for reference marking in literature. These are some of the references. Thank you so much.
Very nice paper, Dr. Saurabh.
Thank you, ma'am.
Once again, how many patients have you done with toric lenses?
With using this marking?
No, just toric lenses in general.
Toric, I must have done around 500 to 600 lenses so far.
And what would have been your complications in converse to this? How many patients have you done with this?
Retroillumination? I generally use the standard marking because most of the patients are cooperative.
Right.
I have used this particular method specifically, though I have used it in this study, specifically for pediatric cases. I have done three so far, and
okay.
One of the case I showcased. And all these patients, even post-operatively, the results were bang on.
Okay.
And I think in pediatric case, I was actually, this idea I got from a pediatric cataract because the patient had almost four diopters of astigmatism, and he didn't allow me to mark. So I just thought that I should take an image and then let's see. And that went perfectly well. I used in three other cases like that.
Very innovative. And how did you put yourself into getting the retroillumination app, Play Store?
No, I have made this app. This is a standard app just okay. like ToriCam.
Okay.
Only additional thing is it is on Android platform.
Okay.
And it gives you a corrected axis of placement. So whatever error is there in the marking, generally, we doctors get confused whether you have to rotate it clockwise or anti-clockwise.
Correct.
But it will calculate itself and give you a new axis of placement. So that will avoid all the errors in the marking.
Thank you very much.